Myself, Mr. V.V.Anagire, Assistant Professor, Department of Electronics and Telecommunication, WIT Solapur. Friends, today we are going to study IDEs, that is Integrated Development Environments used in Embedded Development. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to use IDEs for development of an embedded application. So friends, before starting with IDEs used in embedded development, you have to pause this video here and you should recall which IDEs you have used to develop a mini project and how we are going to use that IDE for development of a small project or small scale embedded project. First point is embedded software. So embedded developer is going to execute software which is to be present in its hardware. So thing is, embedded hardware will remain same, and based on application the software will go on changing. So for different applications, different type of embedded softwares are to be used. So thing is, the hardware will remain same and we can embed software or we can burn different ROM images into the same hardware for different applications or to upgrade a current system. So to create software, the following basic components are to be needed. Into that, first one is operating system. So different type of operating systems are there which are going to be used to design embedded application. So Windows CE, Linux, ThreadX, Nucleus, RTOS, so such type of operating systems are to be used. Languages. So the program is to be written in different type of languages. So into that, C, C++, Python, JavaScript, Visual Studio, these type of languages we are going to use. Tools. So IDE, PDK, SDK, compiler toolkit, toolchains, hardware and software debugger. So these type of tools we are going to use. Example is ST-Link, Sager. Now we will see types of some embedded software development tools. First one is editor. For writing C code or assembly mnemonics using the keyboard of personal computer, for entering the program we are going to use editor, which creates a source file that stores the edited file. So generally we have to use editor to write C or assembly language code or C++. So for these purposes we are going to use editor. So GNE is a good example of text editor. This is a small and lightweight environment that uses the GTK plus toolkit, and this GNE supports C, Java, PHP, HTML, Python, Perl, Pascal and some other types of files. Next tool is compiler. So a compiler is tool used for transforming high level programming language code into low level machine language code. So when user write a program, so that program is in the form of high level language. So the compiler will convert that high language programming code into low level machine language code, so that a machine machine can read the low level language. So the conversion from high level language to low level machine language is to be done by compiler. So Keel C51 is a popular compiler that creates app for 8051 microcontrollers and translates source code written in the C language. So this Keel C51 will perform the task of converting a source code which is written in C language into machine language or low level machine language. Next type of tool is assembler. For translating assembly mnemonics into binary opcode, that is into an executable file called binary file, we are going to use assembler. So that assembly mnemonics is to be converted into binary opcode or binary codes, which is to be executable file. So JNU assembler, that is GAS, is widely used for Linux operating systems and can be found in the Macintosh tool package. Next, debugger. Debugger is a tool used for testing. It eliminates bugs and errors, notifying places where they occur. Debuggers identify the lines where issues are found, so programmer can address them quickly. So generally, debugger is to be used to detect error so that we can correct that error and the embedded system or that embedded application which is to be developed is to be error free. A good debugger tool is IDE Pro that works on Linux, Windows and Mac OS X operating systems. It has both free and commercial versions and is highly popular among developers. Linker. Linker links codes with other codes required. Linking is necessary because of the number of codes to be linked for creating the final binary file. So generally, embedded application is to be developed with the help of small codes. So generally, all these small codes are to be linked with each other. So linking of these small codes is to be done by linker. If we consider a simple example, that if we have writing a code for blinking of LEDs, so in a main program we call delay subroutine. So generally, delay subroutine program is stored at somewhere in the another memory location. So linking of the main program with that delay subroutine is to be performed with the help of linker. So JNU IDE is one of the linker tool which we can use. Next tool is emulator. So emulator is used to simulate all functions of an embedded system circuit, including that or additional memory and peripherals. It is independent of particular target system. So this emulator is to be used to check how that application works in real time environment. So it is exact replica of that system which we are going to be developing. So all these are the tools to be used while developing any embedded system. But thing is, all these tools are necessary while developing any embedded application. So all these are must. So all these tools are to be included in a single package or in a single system. So for that, we have to use IDEs. So IDE is Integrated Development Environment. Talking about the list of embedded software development tools, we can't but mention Integrated Development Environments. All the above mentioned tools are needed for creating your embedded software. But it would be extremely inconvenient to use them separately, as I said before, so adding another layer of complexity to the project. So hence, to simplify the development process, it is highly recommended to use integrated environments. So IDE is software that provides a set of necessary tools in one package. So these are some embedded software development tool list, that is IDEs, we are going to use while developing an embedded application. So into that, first one is ArmKill, next WebStorm, next one is Arduino, which is to be generally used or In many educational systems, regular practice is to be done on Arduino IDE, Next, MPLAB X, Visual Studio, Eclipse, NetBeans, and MATLAB. So these are some IDEs or embedded software development tools which we are going to use to develop any embedded application. And these IDEs will include all these tools like emulator, linker, debugger, assembler. So all these are to be included in this IDEs. While preparing this video lecture, I have referred Internet of Things by Raj Kamal and the webpage. Thank you.